all things come to an end, so does our burner, so let's see how to make this back end. The easiest and most simple way to do it is to put this in a lathe chuck, use the boring bar, make this hole round inside, make the corresponding steel plug, just shove it inside, weld it around, and then all you have to do is put it in a lathe, use a center drill, drill the hole, tap the hole like this. As you can see, this is our nozzle holder, and that's pretty much it. So that was easy way. Another way to do it is to take this piece of steel, at least 5 millimeters thick, so it won't bend when you weld it, and punch the hole, and then use the calipers and make a circle like this with the scribe. Put it on a drill press, drill 10 millimeters hole. Make another one, but without the scribe circle. All you have to do then is take all threaded rod like this, and then you use your body of the burner, align these two like that, use another one of these plates that we made with the hole, and just, you know, put it over the thread and screw it in, and this won't go anywhere while you weld it. After that, tack weld this nut and do the same thing as I did on this burner. Just tap the small hole through the nut. You can use the coupling nut, even better. And that's pretty much it for that type. Another type you can do is by using 4 screws. So 2 would go here like that in the center. Other ones would be a little bit lower, but 90 degrees apart. And with that, you can aim this pipe that would have 10 millimeters inside diameter for our nozzle that goes inside. Okay, so once you aim this perfectly by tightening or loosening the screws, make sure that this pipe sits perfectly inside, in the center. Use the nozzle, of course, and then check it out. Once you get it to run through, all you have to do is cut a disc like this. That's the same diameter as inside, and just shove it through this end until it hits this small pipe. Then you can use silica sand and glass water, water glass, I always mix those two, and pour it inside. Once it cures, it won't go anywhere. Drill a small hole through this and through this pipe, run a tap through it, and you're done. Another simple way to do it, just score some scratches, deeper scratches in this pipe so that it cannot go back and forward, but that's how you do it. Okay, so let's go to our nozzles itself. There are 2 types that I made. As you can see, one is on the thread. This is 10 millimeters pipe, as you can see. This is a hydraulics pipe, and the inside is 692, 7 millimeters. 6.8 is for M8 thread, so it won't bother this thread, it won't leak as long as you put Teflon tape around it. There is enough meat for wall thickness. After all, this is not some insanely high pressure, and these hydraulic pipes are made for 180 bars, so it's a tough steel. So no problem with that. You can also use air brake lines as well. You can make them from stainless steel as well. So how do we connect this to this piece? This is 1/4 plug that I use on my valve. Okay, show you. like that. And no, this duct tape isn't holding the the nozzle together. It's just there to hold this wing nut that I put, so every time I get the same distance. This nozzle I made, I think around 10 centimeters long. So let's see. Yeah, around 10 centimeters. So that's a perfect size for it. It will leave a little bit of play for you. So all I had to do is tap the hole. Let's put this away. All I had to do is tap the hole. M8 thread for this M8 nozzle tip. You can exchange them really easily, and one of these will fit all of your burners except 1/2 inch, because that one is very small and you need a smaller pipe for it to work. On the other end, you can make a thread. This was made by a cheap set of M10x1 thread and tap and die set. It would cost me around $10 on eBay. Then you can tap this plug, as you can see. This doesn't have to be straight or anything. So you just put a Teflon tape and that's it. Of course, you can always drill this plug and just weld the pipe around it. That's two ways to do it. Another way is a little bit more complicated. It involves soldering, so brazing, my bad, brazing. So you will have to have a torch, but if you have it, you can make a nice nozzle like this. This one I made for one half of an inch burner that I'm going to build. And you do it like this. This is 8 millimeters, as you can see, 8 millimeters. Air conditioning pipe. I found this on junkyard. I didn't bought anything but the tips. And then you take M6 0.6 MIG tip, and as you can see, it has some end play inside. So to fix that, all I did was I put small copper wire from old angle grinder that died winding. Just make sure to remove the varnish from it by using sandpaper and just run it through, and then you wrap it around and put it inside the pipe. But before we do that, I prepared this copper by dipping it inside this pickling solution. And this pickling solution is made from white vinegar and salt. White vinegar 70%, 30% salt. When you put it inside, it eats away the copper and it leaves it perfectly clean. Once you have done that, use acetone, or you can use ethanol alcohol or isopropyl alcohol, and clean everything. Once you have done that, your tip is ready to solder. My bad, braze. For that, I have used this copper alloy. It's copper phosphor alloy. It's commonly used for refrigeration, as you can see. 645 Celsius. Okay, let me see if I can zoom in. Wait, there was something. Nope. This one has copper, phosphor and silver inside. And for the love of God, I cannot find it where there was a name for this. I think it was inside somewhere. Well, anyway, It's a brazing rod. It's commonly used for air conditioners, heating. So probably the stores that do that business will have. Then all you have to do is I cut a little bit of ring and I bent it around the drill bit and I put it over it. And all you have to do is take your torch and heat up this bottom part. Heat it evenly around, because brazing will go, solder, silver solder will go where the heat is. And this made quite nice braze, as you can see. This is my first time, so I'm happy how it turned out. Then all I had to do is I used some file, I put this in a vise, clamp it gently and just use the file to make it this needle-like. The other part was a little bit trickier. This is a brass plug. I drilled a hole that is 0.5 millimeters larger than this diameter, so 8.5. I had to make a jig for this, and jig was a piece of steel that I have drilled a hole inside, and then I put this copper pipe first, and I put this brass plug like that. And then I cut this wire and I bent it around the drill and I put it inside this. And all you have to do then is you need to have a strong torch, because this is one giant heat sink. You can use a little bit of cotton, make sure it's wet, put it inside and then fill this pipe with the sand. Wrap it around if you have some kind of wool, for example, from rock wool or from the oven. Oven has sides with that wool. Basically do anything to reduce the heat capacity of this, because this is one giant huge heatsink. And then just heat it from the top until it melts like this. Okay, as you can see, I made it stick out a little bit, and then I just used the drill bit to smooth this out, and you end up with nice nozzle like this. I also used I didn't had flux, so I used this boric acid. This is I think it was 40% boric acid, and other thing was 96% ethyl alcohol, but anything that burns will do, isopropyl as well, because all you need to do is dip it inside, and then when you burn it, it leaves a nice coat of boric acid. If you have borax and boric acid, you can mix it together inside the jar. Although borax is the salt in boric acid, but when you add it a little bit more, it turns out into really, really nice flux for soldering and brazing. Also, one another cool thing about the boric acid is it burns green. Wait, I need a lighter, just a second, I will show you, it's awesome. Okay. So let's find something to burn. It's really cool, guys. Okay, I will dip this piece of cardboard. I love this. And as you can see, it's a green flame. How cool is that? And as you can see, it left a residue. Let's do it again. Screw it, why not? I feel like Harry Potter. Okay, now let's get serious again. So I used this as a flux. It turned out to be good. So that's the way you can do it if you want to braise it like this. Well, that would be all for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching, and until next video, goodbye.